During Hank and John Green's podcast, episode 304, they were asked to consider a pan balance. On each side of the scale, there's a bucket, halfway filled with water, so the scale's balanced. If I take my hand and I put it into one of the buckets, which way will the scale tip? Will it move at all?
Sometimes when I'm trying to figure this stuff out, Hank, what I do is I imagine a much larger situation.
Okay.
So, like, imagine a building.
Uh-huh.
That has an arm. And the building's arm has a hand. And that hand is in a gigantic bucket of water.
I think if this was a job interview and I threw you this question and you gave me that response, I'd be like, hired. That's the kind of thinking we need. Giant building with an arm. And on that arm, a hand. And in that, and that hand, in a bucket. Now it all makes sense, doesn't it? If you just take a bucket and you put a lemon in it, then that bucket weighs more, right? The lemon, if it was just sitting on its scale, it would weigh a certain amount. You put that lemon in that bucket, it yes. increases the mass yes. of the situation.
Yes.
So now you have a lemon man, and he's got a lemon arm with a lemon hand.
We have the same problem, though. As long as the lemon is his lemon hand is connected to his lemon arm, it's only because the lemon is cut off from his lemon body that the lemon.
But is it?
I think the weight of the bucket increases mm-hmm. by one lemon, and I think the uh-huh. weight of the lemon person has to decrease by one lemon. Right?
John had the right idea of exaggerating the situation, but instead of exaggerating how large your hand is, think about exaggerating what kind of liquid is in the cup. Instead of water, think about honey. It takes a force to push your finger into the cup of honey. It's the same thing with water, it's just not as extreme. We can prove this reaction experimentally.
The cup of water weighs 711 grams. When Nathan puts his hand into the cup of water, it weighs 830 grams. This means that the force exerted by the water on the scale increased by about 120 grams when Nathan added his hand.
Newton's third law states that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. When swimming in water, we can feel a buoyancy force that keeps us afloat. This force, like all others, has an equal and opposite force on the water. This accounts for the change in force exerted on the scale.
Let's calculate this. By thinking like an engineer and minimizing the variables, we will replace our hand with an object of known volume, like a bottle of teriyaki sauce, not sponsored. Then we can predict by how much the imparted force will change. First, we have to list our assumptions. We're assuming the density of water to be 1,000 kilograms per meter cubed, and the acceleration due to gravity to be 9.81 meters per second squared. From fluid statics, we know that the buoyant force equals density times gravity times the volume of the submerged object. After crunching those numbers, we got that the buoyant force on the teriyaki sauce equals 1.84 newtons. We can convert this value to grams using F equals ma, and we get 187 grams. To prove our calculations are correct, we dipped a bottle of teriyaki sauce into water on our kitchen scale. As you can see, we measured about 186 grams.
Intuitively, it's pretty hard to think about the effect that buoyancy has on the water and how these forces balance. However, through a pretty simple experiment and through pretty elementary calculations, we can visualize this much clearer.
Hank, John, viewers, we hope we've effectively answered your question. And as the Green Brothers always say, don't forget to be awesome.